சதாசிவசமாரம்பாம் சங்கராச்சாரியமத்யமாம் அஸ்மதாச்சாரியபர்யந்தாம் வந்தே குரு பரம்பராம். டுடே ஐ வில் கிவ் யூ தி இன்ட்ரொடக்ஷன், ஜெனரல் இன்ட்ரொடக்ஷன் டு த உபனிஷத்ஸ். அன்டில் நவ் வி கம்ப்ளீட்டட் 6 உபனிஷத்ஸ். ஐ ஹோப் ஆல் ஆஃப் யூ ரிமெம்பர் அட்லீஸ்ட் நேம்ஸ் ஆஃப் த உபனிஷத்ஸ். முண்டகோபனிஷத், கேனோபனிஷத், கடோபனிஷத், கைவல்யோபனிஷத், ஐதரேயோபனிஷத் அண்ட் தைத்திரேயோபனிஷத். 6 உபனிஷத்ஸ் ஓவர். இன் ஆல் உபனிஷத்ஸ் ஐ கேவ் த இன்ட்ரொடக்ஷன் ஆல்சோ. நவ் வி ரிவைஸ் ஒன்ஸ் அகெய்ன் தட் இன்ட்ரொடக்ஷன், த இம்பார்ட்டன்ஸ் ஆஃப் த ஸ்டடி ஆஃப் தி வேதாந்திக் ஸ்கிரிப்சர்ஸ். வி கேன் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் ஓன்லி வென் வி அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் த இன்ட்ரொடக்ஷன். த இம்பார்ட்டன்ஸ் ஆஃப் தி ஸ்டடி ஆஃப் பகவத்கீதா, உபனிஷத்ஸ் அண்ட் பிரம்மசூத்ரா, பிரகரண கிரந்தாஸ், ஆல் தீஸ் பிரஸ்தானத்ரயம் அண்ட் பிரகரண கிரந்த ஸ்டடி, தேர் ரிலவென்ஸ், தேர் இம்பார்ட்டன்ஸ் வி கேன் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் ஓன்லி வென் வி அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் த இன்ட்ரடக்ஷன். த ரீசன் ஆஃப் திஸ் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்டிங் இஸ் there is a possibility of what you can call negligence in study, not taking seriously the study. The reason is mainly not understanding the introduction. Therefore I consider introduction is the most important topic to be grasped. 99% of students do not know the significance of the study of the scriptures. The reason is introduction is always in the beginning it comes. They consider we have not yet entered the text. We have come here only to study the text. Whatever text we buy, that teacher has not yet opened. Therefore, they don't take it, this introduction, seriously, naturally. Because text is important, text has not yet opened, only introduction dani. But that is not right vision. It happens. Deliberately they don't do, but it happens. A serious mumukshu student is one who grasps the introduction properly and assimilates, then the study works. Even though all of you know that introduction, deliberately I am again revising, but I keep forgetting. Therefore I want to revise for my sake. I love that introduction. I am not tired of teaching that introduction, because this Upanishad happens to be the last Upanishad for this class. So normally 6 Upanishads only we teach. This Aitreya is one bonus Upanishad, Vaisa. Totally 7 Upanishads. But after this Upanishad, what we will teach Swamini, I will tell you later what I will teach. But this Upanishad itself takes 1.5 years, 2 years nearly. Because it has got 4 chapters, Mandukya Upanishad. So let us see the general introduction to Vedantic scriptural studies. Vedas are the primary source of knowledge. We consider 4 Vedas as the primary source of knowledge. They considered as apaurusheya granthas. Apaurusheya means not born from purusha buddhi. Whatever is born from the purusha buddhi, human intellect, it is called paurusheya grantha. What is not born out of human intellect, that is apaurusheyam. Our Vedas are not paurusheyam but apaurusheyam. When they are not given by the human intellect, who gave those Vedas? A question. We know that Vedas given by the Lord Bhagavan only. Bhagavan only is the giver of these Vedas. How Bhagavan gave these Vedas? All the Vedic Shabdas are there in the cosmos at the time of creation itself. Just as the radio, television, in the form of waves, the sounds are there in the cosmos. They are received by our set of box or some TV or radio. There is a transmission center and receiving center. Bhagavan is called transmitting center. And our rishis are called as receiving centers. The Vedas which are given by the Bhagavan, they are received by our rishis. How rishis are able to receive that Veda mantras? Because of their sattvic tapo balam. Sattvic tapo balam, not rajasic or tamasic tapo balam, but sattvic tapo balam, because of their power, their austerity. They have received the mantras. Having received the mantras, they taught to the next generation. This teaching is also later through Karna Parampara only. One Guru, Maharshi, just reveal those mantras, then the student, Sishya, will listen. It is called Karna Parampara. No notes, no textbook, no printing, and no cassettes, no CDs, nothing is there. Person to person they sit opposite each other and this guru go on uttering the mantras. The student listen through the ears and learn. Rigveda, Yajurveda, Samaveda, Atharvana Veda, 4 Vedas. Each Veda contains thousands of mantras and they learn just through their ear. They hear and they reproduce those mantras. If you go to any Yajurveda Parayanam or anywhere if people are chanting any Veda Parayanam, they don't keep any book. You might have noticed that. They don't keep any book with them. Just like that they chant. How is it possible? Because of their memory power. Once all these gadgets are available, book, printing, all those books, notes, pen and everything available, our memory power comes down naturally. Therefore, those days they were not having any mantras in printing format. Later only they have come into printing form. They were looking into the book. Even till today, many Gurukulams, Vaidika Patashalas, they don't keep book. All are in their memory. Therefore, it is called Karna Parampara. The tradition which is coming through hearing only, called Karna Parampara. So, four Vedas, why they are called Vedas? There is a significance. Vidanti Chaturvidha Purusharthan Anena Iti Vedaha. Vidanti Chaturvidha Purusharthan. You can come to know the four goals in of human being through Veda. Four goals. Dharma, Artha, Kama, Moksha. Chaturvidha Purusharthan. Purushena Arthyate Iti Purushardhaha. That which is sought after by a person is called Purusha Arthaha. Here Purusha means male or female. Purushena Arthyate, that which is sought after. What is sought after? Dharma is sought after. Punya is sought after by a person. Artha, wealth is sought after by a person. As a goal. Entertainment is sought after by a person. It is a goal. Desires are there. Kama means what? Entertainment. Dharma, Artha, Kama. Even moksha is also sought after by a person. Liberation. Therefore, Vidanti, people know, come to know Chaturvidha Purusharthan Anena, through which Veda. They come to know these four goals of life. They can fulfill these goals through which Veda, by knowing which Veda. Therefore, it is called Veda, with to know. With to know. Another name for Veda is Shruti. Another name for Veda is called Shruti. Shruyate iti Shruti. Shruyate. Just they are heard. Veda mantras are heard by the rishis. Swamiji jokingly says, Receivati iti Rishihi. The one who receives is called Rishihi. Naturally, they are all receivers of those Vedic mantras. Actual meaning of Rishish is Rishati Janati iti Rishihi. Rishati Janati. The one who knows the Veda mantras, they are called Rishis. Mantra Drashtaraha, the seers of mantras. They have seen mantras means they heard mantras. Mantra Drashtaraha, because of their pure mind. So Shruti it is called, Veda or Shruti. Four Vedas, Rig Veda. Tell me what are those names? Rig Veda, Yajurveda, Sama Veda, Atharvana Veda. Four Vedas. First Veda is Padya Rupa Mantraha. In which portion of Veda mantras are in poetical form? In which Veda the mantras are in poetical form, Padya Rupam. Therefore, they are called Padya Rupa Mantraha. In that Rigveda, first Rigveda and second one is Yajurveda. If Rigveda happens to be Padya Rupa Mantraha, Yajurveda happens to be Gadya Rupa Mantraha. Gadya means prose, paragraph form. Taittiriya Upanishad, what we saw, is Yajurveda Upanishad. It is full of paragraphs. But Aitareya, what we saw, is mantra. There is no paragraph. So we have completed all four Vedas Upanishads. Upanishad is the fourth bhaga of Veda. Samhita bhaga, mantra bhaga, Aranyaka bhaga and Upanishad bhaga. Every Upanishad has got four parts, four divisions. Mantra bhaga, Samhita bhaga, Aranyaka bhaga and Upanishad bhaga. So we are seeing the Upanishad bhaga of Veda. Yajurveda is Gadya Rupa Mantraha. What about Samaveda? Giti Rupa Mantraha. Giti means in a musical form. Mantras are in musical form. They are called Giti Rupa Mantraha. Samaveda itself, there are 1,000 branches. 1,000 branches. Each Veda has got branches. One Samaveda has got 1,000 branches. Now 2 branches are available. 1,000 branches, 998 branches vanished. Only 2 branches are available. Even that to study, people are not available. A Samavedi, to get a Samavedi, it is very difficult. Therefore, Samaveda mantras are Giti Rupa mantras. Now, next one, Atharvana Veda, the fourth Upanishad Veda is called Atharvana Veda Upanishad. Atharvana Veda Upanishad is not neither Padya nor Gadya nor Gita, but Atharvana Veda Upanishad is given out by Atharvana Rishi. All mantras of Atharvana Veda given out by the Atharvana Rishi. We saw this Atharvana name, we heard in Mundakopanishad, first mantra. Brahma Devanam Prathama Sambhabhuva Vishvasya Karta Bhuvanasya Bhokta Bhuvanasya Gopta Sa Brahma Vidyayam Sarva Vidyam Pratishtham. Saha Brahma Vidyam Sarva Vidyam Pratishtham Atharvaya Jeshtaputraya Praha. Brahmaji taught first this Vedic teaching to Atharvana Rishi. Then Atharvana Rishi gave out this Atharvana Veda. So these are the 4 Vedas. These 4 Vedas, they are divided into 2 parts. Veda, which is known as Shruti, has got 2 parts. First one is Karmakanda part. Second one is Jnana Kanda part. 2 parts, Karma Kanda, Upasana Kanda also included. Karma Kanda part and Jnana Kanda part. Karma Kanda part of Veda is that where the rituals, rites are mentioned, given. That is Karma Kanda Bhaga of Veda. R-I-T-E-S, rites means R-I-T-E-S, rituals, Karma Kanda Bhaga, doing, you have to do there, doing there. Jnana Kanda, knowing, knowing part and doing part. Performance of rituals come under doing. Jnana Kanda is knowing. knowing the subject matter. So this is the difference. Now this Karmakanda prescribes lot of rituals to accomplish dharma, artha, kama. First, artha, the wealth, to earn wealth, lot of wealth, person can perform actions, rituals, rites, Vaidika karma. It is called Vaidika karma. The one who follows Vaidika karma is called Vaidikaha. The one who follows or performs Vedic rituals, Yajna, Yaga, Homa, all the prescribed activities, functions in the Veda, whoever follow, that person is called Vaidikaha. Hindu word came later, very much later. After Britishers, when they came, that Hindu word was, name was there in our Puranas. Hindu word is there, but Hindu word is not very popularly used. Vaidika word was used those days. So what are those activities, functions? There are three types of activities. Vedic karmas, Vaidic karmas are three types. Karmatrayam. What are they? Kayika karma, number one. Vachika karma, number two. Then Manasa karma, number three. The rituals prescribed by Veda in three ways. One, you can do physically. Kayika means physical activities, where the physical body involves in that rituals. That is called kayika karma. Pradakshinam, doing pradakshinam, doing abhishekam, all those called physical karmas, kayika karma. Then second type of Vedic rituals are vachika karma, verbal activities. Verbally only they chant, not doing anything physically, but stotra parayanam, sukta parayanam, chanting Vedic mantras, all are verbal, all prayers. Verbal activities are called vachika karmani. Vachika means verbal. Then the third karma called Manasa karma. Manasa vyaparaha. Manasa rupa upasanani. Manasa puja. Manasa japa. Manasa dhyanam. Everything Manasa. You need not chant verbally. You need not do anything physically. Abhishekam also you can do Manasikam. Gandham, milk, whatever you do, abhishekam, mentally you can. Even japa also, manasika japa, mentally you can chant the mantra. That is called manasa karma. So the mind alone is involved. You sit silently, without physical activity, without verbal activity, no sound, no disturbance to others. In kayika, vachika karma, you disturb others also. Sound pollution. But initial stages, people require kayika, vachika karmas. Initial stages. After certain age, you don't require that kayika, vachika, because you become old also. Kayika, vachika, Kayika vachika karma you can reduce, you can remove. Remove in the sense, not totally, you can reduce, drop nothing. You can be free in that. So manasa karma is superior than kayika vachika. You cannot do manasika karma without doing sufficient kayika vachika karma. Beautifully designed in Veda, we should not ask why. That prescription is the prescription where no question is raised why. Practice, that's all. So, three types of karmas. Karma trayam. Kayika, vachika, manasa, vaidika karmas. Then, once you do karmas, phalam also will come. Karma phalam comes. That alone is called dhar. First, artha phalam. Artha phalam. Artha means you get lot of money, prosperity, good health. In Taittiriya Upanishad, we saw avahanti homa. Avahanti tanvana kurvana chiram atmanah vasagum simamagavascha annapani cha sarvada tato me shriyamavaha lumasham pashuvis. Lot of things he gets, money, clothes, food, so many things. For that avahanti homa, ayush homa, so many other things to get money, etc. Money, not only money, even people. People also a type of wealth only. Getting a nice person, security. Artha, wealth is for what? Money is meant for what? Security. Another second person, tunai. Second person support is also a type of wealth for security. So to get security, I want that money. I want to be prosperous. That is called artha phalam. By performing rituals, you get this already prescribes. Phala shruti. You perform this, these are the phalam. If you want to get a boy child, you have to perform this ritual. If you want a girl child, you perform this ritual. If you don't get children, you perform this yaga. Like that, prescribe. Ellathukkume irukku. If you have ear pain, do this ritual. If you have eye pain, do this ritual. For everything, even kaal vali mutti valiki kuda irukku. For everything there is a ritual. We do not know that is the reason, you know. For everything ritual is there. So for every pain why you are getting because of some dosha, a pariharam is given there. Therefore, artha phalam gives security. I want to be secure. This is my goal. To be secure, I need people and money. Clear? So, artha phalam. Number two, after earning money, lot of money I have, what I want to do? I want to enjoy. I want to enjoy. Entertainment. Entertainment is a kama phalam. And now I have got lot of security because I have bank balance. Lot of people, servants are there. So many people are helping me. I have lot of security. Now my mind goes for entertainment. Have a nice tour. Nice tour. Those who are religious people, they go to all Rameshwaram, to Kanyakumari, Kashmiram, Kashi, all these places they go. And along with that religious places, they want to go to even Europe tour. Europe tour, Alaska, or go to, what is that, Niagara. They want to see because they have money. Let me see the world. Adi eppadi irukum? Entertainment. Jolly, jolly, you have to want to enjoy. That is the goal of life. Kama is a natural desire for everyone. I want to enjoy. So, kama phalam. For that also, even though you have money, you cannot enjoy. You want to enjoy that also, you need good health. For that also, there is a homa. For good health, there is a homa. You perform that, you can enjoy the pleasure. So for everything, ritual is there. Kama phalam, second one. Third phalam is, not only here, after death also I want to enjoy. not only here, after death also, I must be secure and I must have enjoyment, entertainment. For that, Shastra says the word dharma phalam. Dharma. Dharma phalam, that is, in that, dharma means punyam. Here we call it as punyam. Why person works for punya means nobody comes along with him. Only dharma comes along with him. Mrutam shariram utsrujya. Once the body is dead, mrutam shariram utsrujya. Kashta loshta samam. It is like a log of wood. It is like a stone. Kashta loshta samam. Mrutam shariram utsrujya kashta loshta samam. Bandhava vimukhayanti. All relatives go away from this person once the body is dead. Bandhava vimukhayanti dharmam tam anugachyatina. Dharma only comes along with you. Whatever punya you have done, noble activities, noble karma phalam, that comes along with you. With that phalam, you can go there, Swargaloka, and enjoy that phalam and come back. So, dharma phalam. There also entertainment. Rambha, Urvasi, dance, nice amritam. There also you can have a Gandharva, 24 hours music. December lo the music season here. But in Swargaloka, 360 days music season. Who will miss that? So everybody wants that punya, dharma, through that they can go there and enjoy. That's why veedu varai manavi, veedu varai uravu, veedu varai uravu, kaadu varai puid, sun. Kadasi varai yaru, ani kekpaan, Tamil la song irukkanu sonnuva. Illaya? Adu irukke, namakku gnyapakam irukkaadu avladha. We don't remember. Nobody, kadasi vare yaar, who will come up to last, who will come and nobody will come. But your dharma will come along with you. Punya will come along with you. Therefore, acquire lot of punya. You have to acquire lot of punya. So these are the three phalams mainly, artha phalam, kama phalam and dharma phalam. These three comes only through karmakanda. That's why I am taking only phalatrayam through karmakanda. Kayika vachika manasa karmas come under karmakanda. So phalam also come under karmakanda phalam only. Therefore karma phalam. Artha, kama, dharma, three types of phalam. Phalatrayam. So karmatrayam, phalatrayam. Sadhyatrayam also. We can say dharma artha, purusharthas, sadhyatrayam, goals no matter. Now comes doshatrayam. Three doshas are there, defective. What doshas are there in this artha, kama, dharma? There are doshas. Three types of doshas. Number one is dukkha mishritatvam. Dukkha mishritam. It is associated with sorrow. Artha, kama, dharma, they are all associated with sorrow. Dukkha misritam. Why dukkha misritam? To earn money, to get married, to get children, to bringing up, all these are pain involved. By just sitting like that, money won't come. You have to work hard. And after marriage, you to get children, you have to go to this temple, that temple. After getting children to bring up, you have to earn a lot of money. Bringing up children is a big task. Dukkham is involved there. Dukkham ishritam. Arjane dukkham. After earning, you have to pay tax. If you don't pay tax, they will come and catch you. Rakshane dukkham. அந்த ஆடிட்டர்னு பிடிச்சி இந்த ஆடிட்டர்னு பிடிச்சி டேக்ஸ் பே பண்ணாமலே எப்படியாவது சம்பாதிச்சு பீப்புள் ஆர் ரிசீவிங் மணி. ரக்ஷணே துக்கம், ஆர்ஜனே துக்கம், ரக்ஷணே துக்கம், வியயே துக்கம். யூ ஹாவ் டு ஸ்பெண்ட் மணி. இஃப் யூ ஹாவ் லாட் ஆஃப் மணி பீப்புள் வோன்ட் லீவ் யூ. யூ ஹாவ் டு ஸ்பெண்ட் லாட் ஆஃப் மணி ஃபார் திஸ் எக்ஸ்பெண்டிச்சர் தட் எக்ஸ்பெண்டிச்சர். மணி இஸ் கோயிங் ஆன் அண்ட் ஆன் அவுட் சைட், பேக்கெட் பிகமிங் எம்டி. அப்போ ரொம்ப கஷ்டமாக இருக்கும். வியயே துக்கம், ஆர்ஜனே துக்கம், ரக்ஷணே துக்கம், வியயே துக்கம். வென் யூ ஆர் ஸ்பெண்டிங் ஆல்சோ தெர் இஸ் எ பெயின். கிமர்த்தம் துக்கபாஜனம், வை பீப்புள் ஆர் ஒர்க்கிங் ஃபார் திஸ் துக்கா. தட் மீன்ஸ் ஆல் பீப்புள் ஆர் கோயிங் அகெயின்ஸ்ட் தேர் வெல்பீயிங். தே ஆர் ஆல் ஒர்க்கிங் ஃபார் தேர் வெல்பீயிங். ஹவு அகெயினிஸ்ட், தே ஆர் ஆல் ஒர்க்கிங் அகெயினிஸ்ட் ஃபார் தேர் வெல்பீயிங். இட் இஸ் நாட் வெல்பீயிங், but they are working against to that, not knowing how well being comes. They do not know, but they are working opposite way. So phalatrayam lo dukkhatrayam also there, dukkha misritatvam. Second dosha is in that phala atruptikaratvam. You don't get trupti at all, however much you study, however much you earn, however much you are great. All people are envious of you, but you are not satisfied with what you have. Everybody says unakenna, you are nicely have earned money, you have established, you are qualified, you are so great, and people are praising. But ullukulla this person is not content, not happy. He is expecting something else. Some more he wants. So atrupti continues. I am satisfied, I am content. With given body, are you happy with your complexion? Are you happy with your hair? You ask anybody, no person is happy with his hair or with her hair, but everybody praises that hair is so nice. A person is not happy. Are you happy with your height? No, I am not happy. Are you happy with your complexion? No, I am not happy. Still further, little bit, ketinde irpan. Are you happy with your richness? I am happy with money, but if I have house in that area, it is very nice. Podumai. And comparing with neighbors, relatives, all the time, if you want to be content also, people will come and talk something makes you not to be content. Even if you feel to be content, I am, people come and say, how can you be satisfied with this? You can earn more. For your qualification, you can go there and earn lot. Poch nama nimmadi kali. And everything, you can get a better wife, better husband, in the madri ella suggestions kudupa, better job, better house, better. People will not allow you to be content and happy. For your status, for your glamour, for your like that, they go on provoking the persons. Atruptikaratvam. Then third one is bandhakatvam, bondage. And once we start using them, we depend upon them. It is totally dependency. We want to be independent, we start earning. I want to be independent and starting earning, but this person becomes more dependent. After earning money, he keeps servants. Morning ஒரு servant, afternoon ஒரு servant, different works-க்கு different servants. அந்த servants வரல என்ன, they are also normal human beings only. If they are not healthy, one day or two days they won't come. See your unhappiness. Our own mind has become so disturbed. If servant won't come for two, three days, our mind is so disturbed. Almost people are sick. Some people in the house, they become sick. Driver won't come and sick. Servant varla and sick. Water won't come and sick. For everything, mentally sick. Sick in the sense, mental disturbance, uneasiness. This is called dependence. Dependence is called bondage. Bandha. It binds you. Even children. Dharma abhivrudhyartham santanam, children. But after getting son, daughter, this person, because of love and attachment, bound by that relation. Anything happens to son or daughter regarding their studies or anything, person is so disturbed. That means I lose my freedom. Wherever I lose my peace of mind, whenever I lose my independence, my freedom, that is called dependence. What do you mean by dependence? By depending upon people and gadgets. Many gadgets I am using. Washing machine, grinder, and so many other gadgets I am using. When they are not working, I become handicapped. Almost handicapped. Cell phone is not working. Handicapped. My servant is not coming, I became handicapped. How can you become handicapped? Servant varlana. Adida? That is called bandha. Dosha is there or not? Bandhakatvam. All these dharma, artha kama and bandhakatvam is there. You become addicted to certain pleasures also. If that pleasure is not there, you feel unhappy. That pleasure I want again and again and again. Bandha. In dharma also there is bandha. Why? You go to punya lokas, after acquiring lot of punya, you go to swarga. Te tam bhuktva swarga lokam vishalam, kshine punye martya lokam vishamti kuvam karainile. Inna kuvam pakkathila vandudva, thirupi. After going to swarga, once the punya is over, punya currency is over, kshine punye martya lokam, come back. After living in swarga, coming back, how miserable that life. Romba kashtama irukku. That is why many people, after living in America, they are not able to live in India. We are happily living, but their life become miserable. After living in America, they come here, they feel suffocation, lot of suffocation for them. We are happily living. That is like swarga. People think that is swarga, but we don't think it is swarga. It is narakam. From here people go there and sit at home and seeing the walls. Naalu pakkama wall paathinde irukum. Sevaru paathinde ukarndirukanum. Velila poga mudiyadhu. You cannot go. We do not know who will come and shoot you anytime. Because by seeing your complexion color, they feel. Recently you read that news also. One lady bought a costliest car in America itself. One Indian lady going by the costliest Benz car like that. And the American saw that, you came to my country, I am going by ordinary car, and you have come to my country and earning lot of money, and you are using this costliest car, and abadi shoot pannidam. See, your pleasure, have you read this news? Not at, you do not know. I am only reading newspaper, I think. Anyhow, I am reading newspaper to give news to you. Because you are all sincere Vedantic students, I know. Anyhow. Because, these are all what problems? Bandha. Everything is bondage. It confine your freedom. That is why you see people, those who are having independent big house, I cannot come to class family, I have to lock the house, I cannot lock my independent house. Some people say, I can lock, but dog is there. I cannot leave the dog. I cannot come. You have arranged a dog for security. Now you are security for the dog. So, this is the kadai. Flats and our problem, own house and our problem. People, where they are happy, tell me. Bandha and bondage. That is why Shastra says these three defects are there. Artha, Kama, Dharma. Three defects are there. Then Doshatrayam are there. Some mature people, wise people like you. Some vivekis. Pariksha lokan karmachitan brahmano nirveda manayat. Having seen all this wealth, prosperity, security and all, I thought it is giving a security, but I am more insecure now. Banks are not secure. You are putting lot of money in the banks for security, but banks are insecure. After knowing all this, and person thinks, is there anything defect free in this world? I don't want this doshatraya sahitam. Doshatraya rahita vastu astivan. All this doshatrayam, karmatrayam, karma phalatrayam put together, prayers in Kathopanishad language. Yamadharmaraja tells to Nachiketas, this dharma, artha, kama, materialistic worldly pleasures, worldly prosperity, the materialistic, even heaven also, comes under prayas, prayo marga, prayo marga. One wise person, having seen all these defects, mind is eagerly working for defect-free. This is dosha bhuishtam, dosha sahitam. Is there any nirdushtam, dosha rahitam vastu? For that Shastra says, yes. If there is a dosha rahita vastu, what is that dosha rahita vastu? You come to Jnana Kanda, that dosha rahita vastu is available. That which is free from dosha. There is no atruptikaratvam, there is no bandhakatvam, there is no dukkha misritam. That type of vastu is available, nirdushtam vastun. Then person is very eager to know, what is that dosha rahita vastu, dosha rahita vastun. That is Brahman. Brahman alone is the entity which is free from doshatrayam. There is no dukkha in Brahman. There is no atrupti, dissatisfaction. There is no bandha, bondage also. Dosha rahita, doshatraya rahita, without these three defects, only one entity in the world, it is Brahman. Then person, this intelligent person, Viveki, Pariksha Lokan also we saw in Mundakopanishad. Having seen all these rituals, Kayika Karma, Vachika Karma, Manasa Karma, so many I have done, Pariharams I have done, still I am not happy, content, I am not peaceful, person says. That something which is free from all these limitations, Shastra gives answer. That is called Shreyas. Shreyo Marga. Shreyo Marga means Moksha Marga. Brahman, if you recognize, you are liberated from Dukkhatrayam. Now understand please carefully. Moksha means liberation from three doshas. Moksha means freedom. Freedom from sorrow. In dukkha there is sorrow. In bandha there is sorrow. In atrupti there is sorrow. In moksha there is freedom from this sorrow. Moksha means freedom from sorrow. Freedom from sorrow is called moksha. Moksha, if you want, that means you want freedom from sorrow, this is called Shreyo Marga. In Kathopanishad language, it is called Shreyo Marga. What is this Marga? How to know that Brahman? Dosha Rahitam Brahma, how to know? Please tell me. I was doing lot of rituals, I was doing lot of japa, tapa, dhyanam, puja, so many things I was doing. I am doing also, now also I am doing, but I am not happy. I want to be happy. I want to be secure. Shastra says Brahman alone is dosharahitam, therefore you acquire Brahman. You attain moksha. Freedom from moksha means freedom from sorrow. Freedom from sorrow, first recognize, diagnose why sorrow is coming. Shastra says, why sorrow is coming? You want to be free from sorrow? Yes, I want to be free from sorrow. Now question, inquire why sorrow is coming. I don't know why sorrow is coming. Shastra says, I will tell you why sorrow is coming. Please tell me why sorrow is coming. Because of self-ignorance. Self-ignorance, Atma Ajnanam eva Dukkhasya Karanam. Atma means self, Ajnanam means ignorance. Atma Ajnanam, whose Atma? Your own self. Your own Atma Ajnanam alone is your Dukkha Karanam. Adiki idiki enna sambandham? Ennada Dukkhaniki Atma Ajnananiki enna sambandham anna? That is called sambandha. I told you, know, one example in one class. One person asked, if somebody cut your ears, what you will do? Somebody cut your ears, what you will do? This person said, I cannot see. I cannot see. Ani solittam. Na paaka mudiyadanna. Idenna na ears cut pannina, I cannot see, you are telling na. Aama. Because if he cut my ears, where can I put my glasses? If I wear glasses only, I can see. If they cut my ears, I cannot wear glasses. If I won't wear glasses, I cannot see. Therefore, if anyone cut my ears, I cannot see. Connection irukka illaya? Irukka? Adhe madri, our sorrow and self-ignorance have connection. My family problems, family burdens. You remember that MBBS? Swamiji used that word, MBBS. Life is miserable. Life is boredom. Life is burdensome. Life is struggle. MBBS. This is called samsara. This is called bandha. How to come out of this MBBS? Why at all this MBBS has come? First of all, you think, Shastra says self-ignorance. You have to remove self-ignorance. Ignorance ka opposite in knowledge. Since ignorance is the cause of sorrow, for joy or peace, what must be the cause? Simple answer. Simple answer, knowledge. Self-ignorance is the cause of problem. Self-knowledge is the solution for problem. What is problem? Sorrow problem. Sadness, dukkham, miserable, boredom, burdensome, struggle, frustration, anxiety, tension, guilt, hurt, worry, fear. All these put together called sorrow because of self-ignorance. Self-knowledge is the remedy. Therefore, Brahman is called self. Brahma Ajnanam eva Atma Ajnanam. The Brahman is free from doshas. Brahman happens to be the self, Atma. You have to know Brahman is free from sorrow. That Brahman happens to be the self. Self-ignorance happens to be the cause for sorrow. Self-knowledge is the solution. Therefore, Shastra says, how to know that self, that Brahman? How to know that Brahman? Tell me, where there is no dosha at all. And Shastra puts, Upanishad puts a bomb like, shock like, it gives like a jolt for us. What is that? That Brahman is not outside, not nearby, not far away. Brahman is you. You are that Brahman. The Brahman is secure, infinite, eternal, pure. Brahman happens to be you, yourself. Then this person question, Nana, Brahmana, enak or Brahmada vire, unnu Brahman theriyilena. Brahmada theriyum, Brahman theriyilena. That is called ignorance. You go and study Upanishad, the Shastra Guru teaches you how to know that Brahman. That Brahman is in your own heart, in your own mind, available as consciousness. You study systematically with Shraddha for a length of time with devotion on Guru and Shastra. You study for a length of time, surrendering to Shastra, surrendering to Guru, and study. You will be free from fear, worry, anxiety, sorrow. All problems dissolve, not solved. We don't say problems are solved. If you understand you are the self, Brahman, Atma, that is Brahman, you recognize, you dissolve the problems. We don't solve the problem, we dissolve the problem. What is the difference between solving and dissolving? If we say solving, I solve my problem, you are accepting there is a problem. Correct? I am trying to solve my problem, Anartha. You are looking at the incident situation as problem. That means problem is real for you. You can never solve the problem. If problem is there, you can never solve the problem. Problem is not outside. Problem is in your mind, in your thinking pattern. That you have to change. Therefore, what we say, Vedanta says, Jnana Kanda says, problem is you, solution is you. There is no problem at all. Thinking there is a problem is a problem. Thinking there is a problem, that is problem. Therefore what? Don't think there is a problem. Don't think there is a problem. Then what is there? There is a situation. There is a situation. There is no problem. You are looking at the situation as problem. Therefore, if you convert the problem into situation, problem is dissolved or solved? Dissolved. Because you have removed the problem word from your dictionary. Understand? Therefore, Nirdushtam Brahma Tat Tvamasi, you are. If you are interested recognizing that Nirdushtam Brahma, Dosha Rahitam Brahma, happens to be the self, you have to do self-enquiry with the help of Guru and Upanishad. You have to do that enquiry. Here, knowing only, there is no doing. That is why some of you keep book, some of you don't keep book, some of you write, some of you don't write. doesn't matter but knowing, that is important. Therefore, karmatrayam, phalatrayam, doshatrayam. All these belongs to karmakanda, prayomarga. It is incomplete. Religious life is initial stages, it is important. Without religious life, God, worship, everything, without that, spiritual life is incomplete. Spiritual life is not possible. You cannot come in a right way to the spiritual life. Therefore, religious life is important. Without spiritual lifestyle, religious life is incomplete. Without religious life, spiritual life is impossible. Without spiritual life, religious life is incomplete. Therefore, may you practice puja, japa, dhyanam at home. And that is karmakanda. This is jnanakanda. Both should go together. You can reduce those pujas and all. You can keep them in skeletal form, but come to Shastra. Don't drop them totally. Do that and give more importance to Vedanta and study of Shastra scriptures. So both are like two wings of a bird. With one wing, bird cannot fly. Spiritual life and religious life. Karmakanda, Jnanakanda. But unfortunately, people always bend Karmakanda side. Either they go enter into that, they won't come out. Some people won't enter into Karmakanda at all. Both of them are unfortunate. Intelligent people, they enter Karmakanda, Vedic lifestyle, and they practice, purify their mind, and they come to Vedanta class and they study scriptures. If I know this in my life, Shreyas and Prayas, Dosha Sahitam, Dosha Rahitam, if I know this clarity is there, I never leave Shastra until I get moksha in this birth. What is my top priority? Bhagavad Gita, Upanishad, Brahma Sutra, Prakrana Grandha study. That is my top priority. Wherever my guru is talking, teaching, I go and listen. I don't feel any pain or any strain in studying Shastra. That is my top priority. All others are only secondary for me. This is called Tivra Mumukshutvam. Why I want to have Tivra Mumukshutvam? I want to be free from sorrow, once for all. Free from fear. Therefore, I want to take this as my top priority goal of my life. Nothing can come and stop me. Nothing can obstruct me from this. I can make that possible in my life through my willpower if I have Tivra Mumukshutvam. If I do not know the importance of this introduction, my study will become so casual study. Casual study, you study 10 years, 20 years, even janmas, it is of no use. But sincere study for a few years, it gives phalam, moksha phalam, anandam, nitya anandam phalam. That is jnanam, atma jnanam. How one can miss this, tell me. That is why introduction is very, very important. You have to revise, remember, and all the time this introduction. If I forget the importance of this introduction, my study will become very, very light, and I don't get benefit also. Why I have to give importance to anything else? Tell me now. If I know that my human life, birth, purpose of life is only moksha. What is moksha? Freedom from sorrow. If you don't work for this, you will continue in fear, sorrow, insecurity, limitation. All will continue. Along with you, they come. Uttindi varu. Appo vandhi Swamini, how to come out of problem? Onnu solla mudiyadhu. I cannot give answer. I have given answer first today itself. Now hook to the Guru and Shastra. You have to hook to both of them. Abadi pudichinde irundana solution comes. This is the introduction where all Upanishads. So I want to recapitulate this introduction. I consider this is very, very, very important introduction. With this background, we'll enter Mandukya Upanishad from the next class. Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavasishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.